Today, I'll be teaching you the most easiest and simplest way to implement fall detection using YOLOV8. I'll first take you through the theoretical phase where you will learn how to use simple mathematical concepts to determine whether someone has fallen or not. Then from there, I'll teach you how to convert this mathematical concept into Python code that you'll be able to use to determine whether someone has fallen or not. Ready to do it? Let's get right into it. Alright guys, so before we get our hands dirty in writing some code, let's first go through these slides and see how we'll be implementing this. Okay, so we'll be implementing this considering these two scenarios. And the first scenario is when someone is standing. So in the first, you can see the first robot is standing and the second robot has fallen. So when someone is standing, generally we assume the height is longer than the width. So the H here donates the height and the green here donates the width. So anytime a person is standing, the height value is longer than that of the width. And to the other image here, you can see the robot has fallen. And we assume anytime someone has fallen, the width becomes longer than the height. So considering this vital information, we'll be using some mathematical approach in order to identify whether someone has fallen or not. So over here, we'll be using YOLOV8 for object detection. And when we use YOLOV8, normally when we detect objects, we get the coordinates in the form of some values. So we get x1, y1, x2, and y2. In order to be able to calculate whether someone has fallen or not, we have to be able to calculate our width and height from these particular values, because the width and height is all that matters to us. So to get a width, we have to subtract x1 from x2, and to get a height, we have to subtract y1 from y2. So this will give us the values for the width and the height. The value of the width when someone has fallen will be higher than that of the height. Now, in order to know whether someone has fallen or not, we will subtract our width from the height. And what we'll get is that this returns us a value which we'll call the fall threshold. So whenever the width value is higher than that of the height, we'll get a negative value which shows that somebody has fallen. Because I established the point here that when someone has fallen, the width here becomes larger than the height. So when we subtract the width value from the height, the value that we are left with will be a negative value. And based on this negative value, we are going to put something on the screen that, okay, we've detected a fall or detected that someone has fallen. So this is the algorithm we're using in order to detect a fall. This is a simple one anyway. Let's go ahead and see the steps we'll be using. So the first steps we'll be using is to implement our object detection. So once we are able to implement object detection using YOLOV8, we can be able to extract the coordinates x1, x2, y1, and y2. Then right after getting these coordinates, we can be able to find our width and height by the formulas we've discussed right here. Then getting our width and height, we can calculate the fall threshold. And whenever this fall threshold falls beneath 0 or we get a negative value, we know, okay, we've detected a fall. So apply the falling condition. And in this case, we just put it on the screen that somebody has fallen or someone has fallen. After this, we will conclude, and that will be all for this tutorial. So this is the theoretical aspect of this tutorial. Let's get right and get our hands dirty. So on my desktop, I have this folder here called fall detection. And when I open it, everything we need to complete this tutorial is right here. So we have this video which we'll be using, and it's just a gentleman walking. All of a sudden, he slipped off and he fell. So we try to detect these actions, get whether the person has fallen or not. That's the video we'll be using, and this is the Python file we'll be using. These are the requirements file, so requirement.txt, and the only requirement we need is neutralities. So I'll go ahead and open this folder with Visual Studio Code. Alright, so right here you can see we have all those files, the virtual environment I've created, the classes.txt file, and this contains all the objects in the Google dataset our pre-trained YOLOV8 model can detect. And over here is the video file I've shown beforehand. Then you have the code here, which is the main.py. So I'll take you through this code. I'll teach you what each and every line of code is doing right here. You have the pre-trained weight here, which in your case, when you run the code for the first time, it's going to download for you. So make sure you have internet connection when you are running this code for the first time, or you can download my pre-trained weight I'll be putting on my GitHub repository. The link will be in the video description. So all these files you see here will be made available on my GitHub repository. So just follow the link and you'll be able to get access to all these files, right? Okay, so let's go into the code. Okay, so first things first, we'll go ahead and import these libraries. And once you install Ultralytics, automatically it will go ahead and install CV2. So for the math library, when you install Python, it comes with it. Then you need to install CV2 as well. And then after importing these libraries, what we need to do is to read in our video file. So I'll show you the code responsible for reading in your video file. So right here, you create a capture object, and the function is CV2.videoCapture. And in here, you specify your video file. If you don't have a video file, you want to use your webcam, then you just need to put 0 right here. And that's it. This will pick your first camera. So that's your webcam. If you have a camera connected to it, you can put 1 and so on. But in our case, you are going to use the video file. So you specify the name or the path to the video file. Right after this, the next step is to load in the YOLO model we're using. So we'll be using YOLOV8S. You can choose to use any of the YOLO models just by changing the name there. Then the next step is to read in this classes.txt file we have right here. So we have classes.txt, which I said earlier contains all the objects you can detect. The next step is that since this is a video feed and we'll be taking it frame by frame, we are reading it right here. So red frame is cap.read, and we are interested in this frame. This returns you a boolean value which shows your video is available or not. Then we take off our frame and resize it into this particular shape. You guys should feel free, you can resize this into any shape you want. After resizing, we feed this particular frame into our model for prediction. So all the objects we detected in the video will be in this result variable. What we need to do is to iterate over it for some couple of time in order to get our bounding box information. I have a tutorial on all of this, how to get these informations. So our link will be in the description as well. You can check them out. So we over here, we are just running a for loop on them, getting our x1, y1, x2, y2. Since it's a float value right here, we are casting them back to integer. Then we get our confidence value as well. And you can see we are also multiplying our confidence value using the math.sig. And we are multiplying to by 100 so that we can get it in percentage straight away. Then the next step is to also get the class we are able to detect. Is it a person? Is it a bicycle? Is it a phone? In this case, we are working with person, but since we are reading the whole class, classes.txt file, we are matching the particular class detected. YOLOV8 gives you the class detected as integer value. So you can see class detected, these are integer values. So we are just mapping the integer value which corresponds to whatever we are getting in our classes.txt. So if the value you get is 1, then you know you've detected a person. If it's 2, you know it's a bicycle. But because we are using Python, it starts from 0. So whenever it detects a person, YOLOV8 gives you 0, and then we match this 0 to its corresponding value, which is a person. We are also getting our confidence. Okay, so now after getting all this vital information, what we go ahead and do is to calculate our height and width. And in the slide, I told you to get the height, we subtract y1 from y2. Bear in mind that we are getting those values here. We do the same for the width, x1 from x2. And then we have to go ahead and calculate our falling threshold, which is we subtract the width from the height in order to get our falling threshold. Now, after getting this falling threshold, we can go ahead and know whether someone has fallen or not. Because we know whenever the value here is less than 0, that means somebody has fallen. That means our width value is bigger than the height. That means someone has fallen, something has happened. So we have to put on the screen that okay, we detected that somebody has fallen. So that's what I'm doing right here. So if threshold is less than 0, we just render this text here that okay, fall is detected. and then we give the position and the thickness and the scale. So that's what we are doing. Then the other line here is that we are also rendering whatever we are detecting on the screen. So if our confidence value is greater than 70 and our class that we are detecting is a person, we are just drawing the bounding box using CVSO, and then we are also putting the text of whatever we are detecting on the screen. And in this case, it's class detect. So if we detect a person will be on top of the bounding box. After this, we just show whatever we are getting. So we are showing our frame here, and we have also implemented that when you press the T on your keyboard, everything breaks, the code quits. So this is all for the code, and I think I've done my best to explain it well. If in case you don't understand any line of it, do your best to comment, and I'm ready to give you more feedback on that. So I'll go ahead and run this code and let's see how it performs. Okay, so here we go. It's working. No falling action is being detected so far. So let's see when it slips off. So as at now, the height value is longer than the width. So they are in normal condition. Nothing happens. Suddenly, our guy slips off. Painful action. Let's see. And you can see now our width becomes bigger than the height. So the value will be negative, and now we've detected a falling activity. So fall detected. So this is how easy we can implement this using Python and YOLOV8. All guys, so this is how it works. Even though this may not be the best approach to detect fall, but I think it works in this case. So in upcoming videos, we may also explore other methods of detecting falling activities. So stay tuned. And also, if you like this tutorial, give me a thumbs up, subscribe to the channel, and also share these videos with one or two of your friends. Thanks for watching, and as usual, I'll see you in the next tutorial.